Hello and welcome to TestObject. My name is Christoph and I have the pleasure today to introduce you to our quality report. App testing is very often a very complex and time-consuming task, but not with our quality report. It automatically runs multiple tests of your app to check its basic functionality. Running a quality report is actually very simple and will only take a few seconds. Go to Quality Report on the dashboard and click Run Tests. Afterwards, you only have to select your devices. For our demo, I will choose 3 devices, but you can also have 5 or 10 or only 1. Just do as you please. In my case, I will test on the HTC Desire HD. So that will be the first one. Then we will take the Y-Ascent P7. Oh, here it is. And the LG G3. So I will cover different manufacturers and Android versions. If you want to test a device with specific properties, you can use the filters on top. So select your Android version, manufacturers, resolutions, or whatever you like. So I am done with my selection. We can have a last look. All right, I think we are ready to go now. So we click on Run and the test start. We will execute 3 tests on each device. That means at first there will be an install and launch test. Then we will have a stress test on every device. And in the end, we will make a set of screenshots. That makes for our 3 devices 9 tests in total. As soon as they are complete, we will have a closer look. It usually takes 15 to 45 minutes till the quality report is completed. If you like, you can observe the progress of the test execution or turn to another activity. You will receive an email once the report is complete. Since we don't want to wait for that long, I fast-forwarded the execution. So here we go, the quality report is ready now. Let's have a look at the results. So we already see here that 2 exceptions were thrown, but we should go through the report step by step. The first test is the install and launch test. That is definitely something that has to work reliably before you can publish your app. In our case, the app was installed and launched successfully on all of our 3 devices. If that is not the case, the respective device will be flagged. Whether or not an issue was detected, every test is clickable and includes detailed information. So you have a screenshot, the full device log, and information on the respective app and the device. As you see here, so after the installation and the launch, the app undergoes a stress test that uses the monkey exerciser from Google, which executes a number of random clicks within your app. So as we see, our app threw 2 exceptions. So let's click on one and find out more. What we can see here is that our app stopped working due to a runtime exception. If that error message we have right here is not enough, you can immerse yourself more deeply in the error. That means we can have a look at the screenshot. Here it is. So that's how the app looked like, and especially the device logs. They will give you all the information you need to fix the problem quickly. So we can go back to our last test now. The screenshot test, which gives you a quick overview on how your app looks on the different devices. So it takes screenshots of different activities within your app, as you see here. You can review all these screenshots individually and identify problems with a certain screen. If you don't like what you see, just open an issue. Opening issues is very important, and I will demonstrate that quickly for the exemptions we looked at before. Here's the way again, and Here we create the issue. We add a title, and if you want, also a bug description. You can access your issues afterwards from your app dashboard. Okay, so we save it and go back to our summarized report, which you see here, including the issue we just created. Now we have a beautiful report which you can share. To do so, you can either create a unique link. That means the owner of this link will be able to look at each of the tests and access all available data. So we open a new tab in our browser and open the link. And you will see it looks very similar to your quality report. But what is missing are all the app options for your TestObject account, so the owner of the link also won't be able to edit your report and open new issues. Back to our report, and the other option is to download the results. Can do that either as a PDF, which I did here, and that gives you a basic overview over all your tests, including the screenshots. So let's scroll down, and as you can see, there are no log files or device details attached. But if you want to have all the details, we have another download option for you. So let's close the PDF and go back to downloads. You need to select this other download option and it will save a zip file on your system. This file contains a folder for each of our tests. So you have the install and launch test folder, which includes all the data under its respective device names. So you have the log files as well as all the screenshots and the error message. This concludes our little introduction. Thank you for following my explanations until here. We recommend you to run your quality report as a sanity check before you publish a new app version. As you have seen, it is very easy to work with. Try it out and see if your app has some problems. To find your latest report, go to the quality report section and have another look. Happy testing!